I guess the difference between me and others of, knowing that I can make it, go to college. I wasn't really raised that much in the system. I came to the system when I was, 15. So I kind of was raised by my mother, and she taught me to go to college and, do that. I feel that my only way out is college. I mean, I can't just go and hop into the workforce or.
It's absolutely critical that we start to train young people and give them the life skills they need to be able to survive in the real world. We take, I think, many people who don't have direct experience with the child welfare system, the foster care system, take for granted the fact that they may have grown up in a two-parent home with a fence and a dog, and and everything they needed to know was there. They had the support, they had the financial resources, they had the education, they had everything that helps you to be able to function in the real world. And we take for granted the fact that when you don't have that structure, that information, that learning, those skills are not there for foster care youth. And so we have this really antiquated way, in my opinion, of providing independent living information and skills, assuming that when you reach this point, 16 and a half, all of a sudden, now it's time to start teaching you. When the rest of society who did not grow up in a foster care system, they've been learning that all throughout life.
Because to answer, you guys' question earlier, if you start early with somebody, when they get to that aging out system, it won't be that many problems. They'll have a foundation. This where instead of like me, I'm gonna use me as an example. I aged out. I wasn't prepared. I moved out at 17, so I basically moved out with no money, just the money to pay my security deposit, first month's rent.
If you're looking for somebody to teach you the skills of living on your own, it's going to happen not in a few classroom sessions where you sit down, okay, let's talk about doing your laundry, or let's talk about household budget. It's like a lot of schools teach that in ninth grade, and it's not something that you learn out of a book. You learn it by doing. And in order to really have that take root, it takes stability in a placement, kind of like growing up in a birth family. Someone who's seen you from age 15, 16, 17. You know what? I don't think Lance has quite got this skill. I think I need to assign him to laundry duty, for the whole house for a couple of weeks, make sure he gets it. That type of longitudinal contact with a young person is the best way to make sure that life skills are transmitted. It's holistic. You don't throw a book at it or some type of training class provided by what the Bureau of Milwaukee Child Welfare. They're life skills. They happen in the context of a real life.